Yes, in this, we will be seeing more operations of the ordered linked list. Here, this function will do whether the linked list is empty or not. So the name of the function is empty. And here we check whether head pointer is equal to null. Definitely, if the head is equal to null, it will be there is no node at all. If there is no node only, we will make the head to be null. So in that case, it return 1, else it return 0. Now, searching for an element. Now we would like to search for an element. So because why we are seeing this first is during insertion as well as deletion, you would like to search. During insertion, we would like to use the search in order to know whether that element, the data is already present. If the data is already present, no need for inserting. In deletion also, we will search for an because we would like to delete, say, the element which has node which has the data 40. In that case, it has to search and it has to return the pointer to this node so that this node can be deleted. So now for both, we need this search. Not only for that, for updation also. So let us see this search. The search has three arguments. One is the data to be searched, and other two are pointers, which are returning the previous pointer and the current node, current pointer. So we have two pointers. We'll see the usage of this. Now here, for initially, the previous is made to null. It is pointing to null. So then current is made to point to the head. Let us imagine this is the linked list given. So each this here data field consists of 10, 20, 40, and 90. And in this next field, we have the next node address. You can see that. So it will have the next node address. Now we have other than the head pointer, we have two more pointer, previous and current. The previous current is made to point to the first node, that is our head node. The previous is as the name indicates previous, so it points to a null pointer, made to point to null. Now we have to check. Say for example, I am passing the value 20. Okay, so I have to check whether in the data field the value is 20 or not. But for that, I have to move because initially the current is here. Now the current pointer is pointing to this. Now I have to move the current pointer to this location. So till what? Suppose I may search for 90. So while current is not equal to null, till it reaches the null, then data is greater than the current data. Suppose I am search, suppose the current data is, say for example, I am passing the value as we have seen 20. Now it search. First, let us imagine previously it is null and the current is pointing to this. And S data is what? 20. So this is greater than the current data, 10. Okay, 10 is smaller than the S data. So now it go inside the while loop. Now the previous pointer is made to point here. And the current is made to point to the next. So that is that we have done like this. Previous equal to current. So this pointer. So now this has become this. Now if you see that previous equal to current. Now the previous is made to current. So that how you can do by allocating previous equal to current. So whatever the current is doing pointing, which is nothing but 100. Now the 100 value previous is equal to 100. So now this memory location, it is pointing to this. And then current is nothing but current. Initially the current is pointing to current next. Current next is what? 105. So now it is pointing to this. So now the loop goes. Now here, now it is pointed here. Now again we check the data. Now is it the data is greater than? No, it is equal to. Okay, when it comes, current is not equal to null and S data is greater than. When it checks 20 is equal to 20. So what happens? The while loop comes out. It will not move. So the current is this and previous is this. Now here we check, go to the if class. In if class, if current is not equal to null, which means it is not a enter. The current is not the node which we are searching. So for example, if you are searching 90, that will be the last node. Okay. So if the current is not equal to null and current data is equal to S data. Now it is why here we are doing that. Suppose I have the value 95. I want to search for 95. Now what it will do? It will search this, and it has reached the null. Still, the data is not present. So in that case, this will return a zero. If current is not equal to null, means now it has not reached the end, which means it has found the value. That is the meaning of this statement. If current is not equal to null, means it has not reached the end of the list, so that we are not able to find the data. No. Now in this case, it is not end of the null. It has not reached the end. Here itself, we have found the data and current data is equal to S data. S data is nothing but our 20. It has matched. So now it returned 1, else it returned 0. So when it returns 1, since it has obtained the data, we have whatever we are searching, we are able to form. Now it returns the 1. Along with that, it returns the pointer also, the current pointer, that is 105, and the previous 100. Both will be carried and it will return to the main program, where now it is ready for the manipulation, whether it is insertion or deletion, whatever it is. Suppose I am having the value, I want to search for 25. Imagine 25, where it is not at all present. Now how this program will function? Let us take S data equal to S data equal to 25. Now what happens here? Again the same, previous equal to null and current is pointing this. Then we go inside the while loop. While current is not equal to null, so it will move next. Now this condition, S data is greater than current. Yes, 25 is greater than 10. So what happens? Now the previous is assigned to the current and current is moved to this. Okay, now current equal to move. Now again it goes into the loop. Still current is not equal to null. And S data is here is 20. So it is 25. 25 is greater than the current data. So now what you do? Again, the previous is pointed to this. And current is made to point to this. So how it can be done? First you have to manipulate the previous pointer. If you interchange this line, the whole thing will gone. It will not be proper. The pointer will not be manipulated properly. So first you have to change the previous pointer. So in previous pointer, you write a current location. That is current pointer. And then you move the current pointer to point to the next one by using this next location. Now it has pointed it. Now again it go inside the while loop. Say while is not equal to null, yes, then S data is greater than current data. What is current data here? Current data is 40. S data is 25. So according to thing, what happened? This condition fails. Since this is an unconditioned, this has to be executed. When both are true, only this will go inside. So here 25 is lesser than the current data. So this breaks and it comes out. Now, if current is not equal to null, yes, current is not equal to null. It is pointing to something. And current data is equal to S data? No, because 25 is not equal to 40. So in this case, the else condition will be executed, which returns 0. Suppose I am having the value 95. Imagine you want to search for 95. Again, the same thing. It moves. Then after this, first it will be previous will be null, the current is pointing this, and then the current is moved to this, the previous is pointing to this. It checks if it is greater than 10 is data is greater than the current data. So move. Now here it reaches. Now here it becomes. Now the current is this, and the previous is this. Now still 90 is smaller. So what happens here? S data is 9 greater than the current data. So what happens? It go inside the while loop. And current is also not equal to null. It is pointing to some value. So it again it go inside. Now the previous value is becoming the Current. Now it is pointing that, and current is made to point to the next one where it is a null. Here it is null. So now it go inside and the condition breaks. While current is not equal to null only, it will execute. So here also it becomes false and it comes out. If current is not equal to null, then here, if it is not equal to null here and current data is equal to s, it will return a 1. Else it returns the value 0. So in both case it returns the value 0.